Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure to me today to present to you this e-poster under the title of Seizure Revealing an Angiocentric Glioma. Angiocentric gliomas are rare superficial slow-growing brain tumors with few reported cases. They usually affect children and young adults. They were first recognized as a distinct clinical pathological entity in 2007 and classified as a WHO grade 1 tumors. Seizures are the classical presentation, with over 95% of patients presenting with intractable epilepsy. The origin of this tumor is controversial. The treatment is surgical and the outcome is favorable. We report to the case of a 90-year-old girl who presented for headache with vomiting and several absence-type seizures. Clinical examination revealed a slight right hemiparesis. MRI showed a left frontal lesion of dominant cystic component. The lesion was predominantly hyperintense SANTI2 and hypointense SANTI1 weighted images. It showed no significant post-contrast enhancement. The patient underwent surgery. The mast lesion was surgically resected with left frontal craniotomy. Pathological examination concluded to an angiocentric glioma. Postoperative course was uneventful. The patient remained seizure-free without local neurological deficit. Angiocentric glioma is a distinct group of tumors, grade 1 according to the 2007 WHO classification of tumors of the central nervous system. It is a rare group seen in children and young adults. Refractory epilepsy is the leading clinical presentation, and it is often drug-resistant. These lesions are usually supratentorial. They are T2 hyperintense, T1 hypointense, and show no significant post-contrast enhancement in MRI, as in our case. Histopathologically, angiocentric glioma is firmly established as a unique entity, although its cytogenesis remains unclear. Whether from histiocytic and hepatocytic lineage, or from radial glia or neuronal origins, this distinctive tumor has been commonly observed to behave as a low-grade neoplasm. Gross total resection of the lesion yields excellent results by achieving complete control of seizures and also preventing recurrence. Pathologic diagnosis of this tumor can lead to differential diagnosis difficulties as several common features are shown with other low-grade gliomas. The recognition of angiocentric glioma then permits a diagnosis with a more favorable prognosis compared with other supratentorial glioma characterized by seizures in children. However, longer follow-up periods are needed to accurately establish the time to recurrence and to determine what additional treatment is needed, such as adjuvant chemotherapy or radiation for this newly described brain tumor. To conclude, angiocentric glioma is established as a single entity since 2007, although its cytogenic origin is uncertain. Only 100 cases have been reported so far. This tumor, a low-grade neoplasm, retains an excellent prognosis, a prognosis that can be compromised by refractory seizures. Thank you.